Today I'm going to talk about exclusively pumping. It's a hugely requested video, and it's a video that I've been wanting to do for a long time, but I've been kind of putting off, and I'm going to do it today, and I'm excited about it. So I'm going to share with you the mistakes that I made. I made a couple mistakes, and if I can prevent one of you from making those mistakes, I would be so thrilled. And I'm also going to just share with you what worked for me and how I did things. I'm not actually going to share my journey of why I started exclusively pumping. I've talked about that so much before, and I have previous videos you can look back on for that. And I don't really like talking about it. It's kind of a nightmare in itself. So if you want to know why I exclusively pumped, you can look back at my old videos. When I first started exclusively pumping, I was using like a 15 or 20 year old Medela double pump and style advance. And it was really, really old, and it worked great, but 3 days in, the motor died. And oh my gosh, I about died too. It was terrible. Anyway, so I went and got a brand new one, and I think it was $300, and I used all the old parts from the old one. My car charger worked on it. Everything worked well on it. So if you have a new one, when you're thinking about buying a new one, if you have an old one, you can use like the car charger and, you know, the parts from it. So that was nice. So I got a double Medela pump and style advance, brand new. And I would say my number one mistake was overfeeding my baby. Just because you pump 8 ounces doesn't mean your three-week-old needs 8 ounces of milk. You know what I mean? Obviously, I didn't do that. I didn't pump 8 ounces, but I'm over-exaggerating, but you know what I mean? Your baby doesn't necessarily need to eat every ounce that you pump in a session. And that was a huge mistake of mine, and my baby would get a bellyache and would be crying because he was too full. He drank too much. And I did that for way too long. Makes me mad thinking back about it, but so know that, not to overfeed your baby. Number two, in the beginning, I would pump every 2 hours. So like, I would pump after an hour and a half. I would know, okay, it's coming on 2 hours, I should pump. I would start pumping, my baby would be screaming the entire time I was pumping. So that, I did that for quite a while, and that was not working. So what worked for me is to pump a bottle ahead. So I would have a bottle ahead ready for him, and when he'd start to cry or whatever, when I knew he needed to eat, I would feed him the bottle. And then immediately, you know, he was comfortable and content, and he would be happy doing whatever, sometimes. And I know he was fed, and then right after, immediately after, I would pump. So that was ready for the next feeding. So basically I was feeding on demand, only I was pumping. So you know what I mean? So as he got older, and he would go maybe 3 hours apart or 4 hours apart, well, my body just did that naturally because I would pump right after he ate. So if he went 3 hours, well, then I went 3 hours. If he went 3.5 hours, I'd go 3.5 hours. Same goes for if he was having a cluster feeding and he had a whole, you know, he drank milk and then he was hungry 1.5 hours later, it'd be the same thing. So my body was doing what it would have been doing if I was nursing. So I was pumping on demand is what I like to call it. And that worked so well, and I did that for the entire time that I pumped. Also pumping on demand like that, I never refrigerated any of my bottles. I never needed to. Breast milk can sit out if your house is at a normal temperature from anywhere from 4 to 6 hours. And so I never had to refrigerate any of my bottles. And that was so nice. So I never had to worry about heating them up. You know, once in a while I would have to if I pumped more at night, or you know what I mean. So that worked out really well. About every month, it seemed like every month I'd go through, or even every week or so, it was quite often, I would go through these phases where I thought, oh my gosh, I'm losing my milk. I wasn't pumping as much as I pumped before. And it would always come back around and I'd get more. So it was just kind of a really regular cycle of, you know, I'd produce a lot and then I would produce not as much and then I would produce a lot. And every time that rolled around, I always thought, oh my gosh, I'm going to have to stop. I'm not going to have to supplement. And I never did. I never ended up, it always worked out. And I always ended up getting my milk back, if that makes any sense. So that was always a thing that was always on my mind, is how much I pumped. So I'm just going to tell you now not to worry about it. And if you pump more on one side than the other, that's totally normal. That happened to me also. I've always pumped more on one side than the other. But just try not to worry about it, because that's totally normal to have more milk at certain times of the month than others. Where I pumped, I had a TV tray that I set up kind of right next to my recliner that I pumped in, and I had my breast pump all hooked up, and then I leave it hooked up like that, and then I just rinse the parts out. I left the parts in the kitchen by the sink always, and when I needed to pump, I would sit there, and I used a hands-free, it wasn't a bra, I wish I had a bra, but I didn't. It was like a hands-free pumping thing. It was made by Medela, but it was just kind of a band that I put on, and then I would be able to pump, have my hands free. This might be all over the place, but pumping is so hard. I had a toddler, so he was 2.5, and then a baby, and trying to pump when they're getting into stuff and crying, and oh, it was so hard. Pumping is very, very hard. So if you have a choice, I would recommend breastfeeding if you have that choice, because pumping is so hard, and it's just not, definitely not easy, but it's doable. I've pumped a lot of places, and I got to the point where I just had to be comfortable doing it. When my baby was 8 weeks old, my oldest son got very sick and was in the hospital, and then throughout 3 months, my husband and I spent hours at the hospital taking classes, and oh my gosh, so I was exclusively pumping all that time. So I would pump in the car when we're driving. We'd be, I don't know, all over the place. I pumped everywhere. Like in when my son had to go to the hospital and just got a checkup, I would be waiting in the, you know, in the little room where the doctor comes in. I'd just be pumping while the doctor's talking to us. I pumped in the hospital room. I'm trying to think where I all pumped. I don't know. But I got to the point where I didn't really even care. I'd pump around family, if I was visiting my family or whatever, I would just pump out in the living room where everybody else was, so I didn't miss out on anything, and no one seemed to care, and I was covered up, so it worked out. Pumping is not easy. I struggled with mastitis. I am prone to mastitis. I had mastitis 3 times with my oldest son when I was nursing, and I had mastitis twice this time with even when I was pumping. And it is terrible, terrible. It is so awful. And they knew me. Like when I called, I didn't even have to go in, and they gave me mastitis stuff because they knew who I was, and they knew that I knew that if I had mastitis. So I actually even have some stored in my cupboard that they gave me in case I would get mastitis on the weekend, because it just makes me so, I mean, anybody's so sick. You just feel like you're gonna die. It's awful. And I had a constant plug duct for 3 months straight. And so I would get rid of one and I'd have another one. And sometimes I'd have two at the same time. It was so painful and so awful. So I am the expert plug duct unclogger. I mean, I was really good at it, but I would have them constantly for 3 months straight. It was just terrible. But if you want a video on that, I really did a really good job at knowing how to relieve the pain and get rid of them quickly. So I am an expert on that. So let me know if you're interested in a video on plug ducts. My other pumping videos, I've gotten a lot of negativity, and that really surprised me. There are people out there that just think that breastfeeding is the only way, and if you don't, that you're doing something wrong or that you didn't try hard enough. And I delete all those comments. And somebody told me that I'm not bonding with my son. And that is really not true. I mean, I was so proud of it, proud that I pumped, and feeding him that bottle and holding him close to me and staring into his eyes, that was totally bonding. I would totally bonded with him. And for anybody to say that I didn't get that bonding experience is wrong, because I did. But any negative comments are gonna be deleted, and I'm not gonna respond back to them. So keep it to yourself. I'm proud of what I did. I have no regrets at all. I had some very serious nipple trauma, and my lactation consultant has been in the field for years and said she's never seen anybody as damaged as I am. And I will never look the same again. And I don't even know if a baby could, if I ever had another baby, the baby might have trouble latching because of the damage that I've had. I don't know. But I don't regret it. at all. I have no regrets. I'm proud of myself, and if I can do it, you can do it. Leave any questions below, and I'd love to answer your questions. There are so many things that I wanted to say, but it's hard to remember everything for one video. But that is all I can think of now. Please leave your questions below. I will make a follow-up answer video for this, because I know this is a topic that people have a lot of questions about. And not everybody does it the same way. I'm not saying my way was right or wrong. Everybody has their own way of doing things. So thank you for watching. Talk to you soon. Leave your questions below. Bye.